end of the nation is very close, Vern.
You are very confident about your triumph. Until we open the chest, we won't know for sure if the compass of destiny is really inside.
The chest is in perfect shape after 2,000 years under the sea. No human technology can do that. It's Atlantean, that's for sure.
The ship, the inscriptions, all the pieces fall into place. The compass of destiny is inside. We are going to change the course of this goddamn war, Vern. We're going to change history.
Take it to Mr. Vern's lab and start maneuvers to ascend for air recycling.
This discovery will change it all.
March 25th, 1888. Scientific Officer Log. It's a great day for the captain, who has asked me to begin documentation while he delivers a speech to the crew in the library. After months of searching, at last he found it. He doesn't have the slightest doubt that the compass of destiny is in his hands. An old artifact that, once released from inside this chest, it is supposed to guide us safe and sound to the flame of Hephaestus, the most powerful energy source in the world. The deadbolt has a complex defensive system, and the... Vern here!
Vern, quick! The nation is attacking us! Not a single Atlantean piece can fall into their...
Mon Dieu! Merde! 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 I must hurry to recover the iMac. It's inside of the armory's safe room, and wait there. It's the safest place around. I must hurry to the armory. I must hurry to the armory. No! Blocked! There's only one way to the armory. Going outside. Merde! The elevators are disabled. Going down, it's not the answer. It's a cul-de-sac. Useless gearball. Why don't you open? These elevators don't work either. It's jammed. Oh, mon dieu! Adam and Sean, this is a massacre! But wait, these bullet wounds on Sean, there are no blood drops around. He was shot after he was dead. That's disconcerting. I must hurry to the RP. The library access seems clear, but I must reach the armory. It's jammed. I have to go down to the armory. Maybe I can open the safety hatches from the bridge. It's Ben! Is somebody there? No foes here. Edriel, where's everybody? And Nadine?
The pilot has disappeared. Very likely she has been captured with the others at the library.
What happened? How is that even possible that...
I don't know. The server radars didn't work. Nothing has worked. They crushed us. Damn, Raven.
The Raven? Mad!
Well, that's not the worst of all. The captain has activated the Nautilus self-destruction.
What?
He will never let his technology fall into the hands of the nation.
How much time do we have?
Less than 10 minutes.
Mon Dieu! You are the second in command. Can't you disactivate it?
Only Nemo knows the code. He told me to protect the bridge to speed away as soon as we release ourselves. But the engines are currently paralyzed until the captain reactivates the core. That's why we're still outside.
Oh my God! What will we do?
You are the only one who can do something.
What? The only what? I'm not a soldier.
Well, now you must become one. I will open the hatches to the armory chamber. Once there, take the IMAG and do whatever you can to save the Nautilus.
The IMAG? It's not a weapon. We barely know how to use it or what it can do. What if it sinks us?
What do you fancy more? A quick death beneath the sea or a long life of tortures at one of the nation's penitentiary mines? Move!
I still have some stuff to do. Mon Dieu! It's jammed! He grabbed that paper with his last strength. It's bloodied. I'm coming, I'm coming! Armory here.
Vern, the Opta recorders show that the Raven has cornered the captain and the engine core. Go there. I will open the hatch.
And what am I supposed to do?
Think. You'll figure something out. You're an imaginative guy.
Merde. ceiling kept withstanding. Try it with the iMac. Before dying, he released a paper he was holding in his hand. Locked. The explosions didn't affect the room. I still have some stuff to do. Blocked! I can only use the iMag if I know the possible options. I must find another way inside. Before dying, he left the emergency.
Watch the flanks! Come on, protect the core! Don't let them take it over!
It doesn't work. It must have run out of energy. I could fix the electric board.
Watch the flanks! Watch the flanks! Watch the flanks!
You just don't know when to surrender. Isn't that so?
Of course not. I still have to finish your face.
The Nautilus is at last in the nation's hands. Tell me how to deactivate the self-destruction and take my word as a gentleman. I will free your crew.
Gentlemen, I saw in the penitentiary mine what to free means to you, you damn sadist. I will die before releasing the Nautilus to your masters.
It's a shame to end our relationship like this, but wish granted, Captain. This time you will not escape. Brothers, take aim!
No! What am I doing?
Vern, what are you doing?
What the? Oh, you must be Mr. Vern, and that thing you're threatening me with is the amazing Atlantean artifact I've heard so much fuzz.
Release them and get out. Don't move. Get back.
60 seconds to self-destruction. 60 seconds to self-destruction.
Don't be stupid, Nemo. Stop the countdown before we all die.
No.
Then say goodbye to your dear Vern.
No!
What the? Again? No!
Vern! I will find you!
The iMac had never displayed that amount of power before. My mind was dragged again to the bridge, an image that was torturing me over the last months. I didn't wake up until a few hours later. A time that surely Nemo felt was like an eternity.
If you think that fear, destructive imagination, and hopelessness don't exist.
Captain, my take is that the only way to open it safely is exposing it to the iMac.
Are you sure?
This deadbolt is a piece made by Phobos priests. Their devices were famous for being impenetrable, forged with the remainders of a meteorite. If anyone messes with it, it will launch a discharge of an energy that will cause a deep, infinite terror to whoever receives it.
An energy that causes terror? That's preposterous.
Maybe for you, but for the Atlanteans, the power of Phobos was real enough. Do you think that fear, destructive imagination, and hopelessness don't exist?
Not presented in the shape of fireworks and sparks.
If you don't believe me, feel free to break the chest with a crowbar.
How can the iMag open it?
The iMag feeds itself with Mr. Vern's imagination and uses it to creatively change our reality. Therefore, it's a positive force, directly opposed to the kind of energy that the deadbolt uses. I'm reasonably convinced that the energy of the iMag will nullify the one in the lock.
You mean, like sand and rust?
Could be. The deadbolt is a rusty key, and the iMag, the sand that wipes away when scrubbed.
Do it, Vern.
What the...
What now?
The iMag. It doesn't work. It looks like it ran out of energy. That explosion must have dried it up.
You must make it work. We must release the Compass of Destiny from this chest.
Shouting at me won't help.
Adriel, go and look for Petrov. May he bring the torch and...
Captain, I must advise against force opening the chest. Unless you want to lose your mind. What is imperative now is to find an answer to why the iMag is dead.
If you have any theory, spit it out now.
It's possible that, given that the iMag gets its energy from the imagination of its host, the problem is inside your mind, Vern.
In my mind?
Yes, that's true. You talked about hallucinations.
Yes. For an instant, I traveled back to a bridge in Paris. I had a similar vision at the island.
Do you remember seeing something like this in your vision?
It certainly has a likeness with the shadow I saw at the bridge, but are you telling me that I saw Phobos, the Atlantean god of fear?
Fear is a narrow description of what Phobos really meant to the Atlantean people. For them, he was the destructive imagination, the one born out from despair and angst. You could also say that his sister Placea, however, represented fantasy. But the truth was that she was perceived as the source of the creative imagination, the one that thrives from hope. I think that Atlanteans believed that the balance between the two brothers dictated one's own sanity. If Phobos has broken that balance in your mind, that would explain the iMag's silence.
Mythology? You're talking about mythology? I don't believe in Phobos, hence it's impossible that it's harming me.
The thing here is, you are afraid. Too much fear inside you. Until you don't master it, I'm afraid that the iMag will never work again.
I refuse to believe in Hocus Pocus.
And how can you explain the iMag blast? It saved your life.
I don't question that the Atlantean technology doesn't work. What I mean is that—
Enough with the debate! We are losing precious time. What matters is that the iMag only works with you. It's obvious that your hallucinations are a symptom of some kind of disorder. Visit Dr. Cedric and get yourself a neurological check. That's an order.
All right.
You, Adriel, check the reparations. We must keep afloat for 2 days until we get to the base. We must assume that Commander Hetzel is not far from us.
Yes, Captain.
Why are you still here?
Aren't you bothered by the way we were attacked? They fell upon us too easily. It's more than probable that there is a traitor on board.
A traitor? In the Nautilus? Never. I have personally chosen each member of this crew. There is no question that the nation has found a way to decode our communications.
I envy your confidence, Captain. But you should be aware that during the attack, I found that someone shot Shun's body after his death. I believe that the murderer was trying to hide the fact that he was killed before the boarding.
God damn it. Let's keep our eyes opened. If there is a traitor in such a small space, he or she will be exposed sooner or later. God damn it!